as the music pops out here from the DJ. It is Saturday night after all. There is the lineup now for the fourth match. It's 2-1 now, advantage Japan. And the Japanese player coming back on is Sayaka Hirano, who played the first match, beating Britt Erland 3-1. Smooth Japanese technique. And there we saw some of her credentials earlier on. There it is again. So lots of experience. World ranked at number 22. And again, came through to win the first match here in this, the last of the quarterfinals. China already through to play Singapore. Hong Kong waiting patiently for the winners of this tie. And on the other side, on the near side here, in the orange of the Netherlands, left-handed pen holder Li Jiao. What a match we saw earlier on this evening when she defeated Kasumi Ishikawa 3-2. World ranked at number 13, 41 years old, but played superbly in that second match here in this tie to secure that victory for the Netherlands. The only point now the Netherlands has, 2-1 they trail, 1-2. And in fact, these players, Adam, have played once before, and it was back in the 2010 Indian Open the World Tour, yeah.
Johnny, what happened?
It was Sayaka Hirano who won 4-1.
Ooh. So a lot of pressure on Li Jiao to change things up right now, but she's handled it well in the past, as we saw in her match against Kasumi Ishikawa. Outstanding serve, an ace to start it off.
Wow.
You know, that's an interesting thing. We've seen very strong legs for Hirano, but they're often sort of a wide stance, seems like a little bit slow movement, a little hoppier. I wonder if that's something that Li Jiao noticed that inspired that serve wide to the forehand. And you could see the hesitation on that receive. She was ready to move wide if she needed to. Ball right back into her body. Very smart 1-2 combo for two serves from Li Jiao.
And she served exceptionally well, didn't she, against Kasumi Ishikawa as well?
Absolutely. Great spin variety, placement variety. And late in the match, there was a lot of that. Attempts at short balls. Some were good, some fell short, too short. Look at that placement right down the line. That is a gutsy, gutsy shot. Li Jiao knows she's gotta have no regrets here and just go for what she can.
She is playing exceptionally well.
Now that's more of the game we remember her playing, being very set on the backhand corner, blocking, sort of controlling the placement, and then stepping out wide to the forehand when she needs to. So far, the service has been so strong, and that beautiful forehand attack down the line. We forgot what her playing style was. Beautiful serve, much better response than the receipt from Hirano as she spins it back up. Don't think Lee was expecting that ball and did not have an easy third ball opportunity.
I just wonder how much energy Li Jiao has left.
Or how much candy the coach has.
That's true. But she was phenomenal against Kasumi Ishikawa. Deuce in the fifth. Sure. But again, we talked earlier about her economic style. It's the one thing that she's got going for her, given that she's played long matches. We're day six, quarterfinal stage. The fact that she's economical in her style, backhands, forehands, movement around the table, is an advantage, but nonetheless, formidable effort. And it's not even always the physical side, it's also the mental side.
And the mental has a lot to do with the physical. After a match like she played earlier, depending on the coolness and the headspace she's in, the muscles react very differently, tend to tighten up, and it can cost you later in the day when the adrenaline settles down.
It's
Very clever play from Sayaka Hirano. She's let Li Jiao come at her because she's comfortable with the block. And then she's blocked her down into the backhand side. Look, watch how she just turns the wrist, softly does it, pins her on the backhand. Li Jiao can only just play it back softly but high. Allows Sayaka Hirano to punish it.
Caught the edge of the table, but still an excellent serve, as wide and deep as they come. It almost caught both edges, the absolute corner of the table.
Great service action.
I like what you said about Hirano's confidence, keeping the ball deep on the table and letting Li Jiao open up. Very nice covering there on the forehand from Li. At full extension, able to get the paddle on top of the ball. One here, and watch this. Ooh, reaching shot, just covering and still coming back to cover the backhand side. Jiao needs to win this one to send it to a fifth and deciding match in the overall match for Netherlands. Nice forehand attack, big spin shot cross court, and Hirano having trouble blocking it. It's a 1-point lead for Li Jiao. Outstanding pace on that block and the redirection. Wide to the forehand, Hirano spins it in and then blocked fast back to the backhand. Li Jiao is a master of using the pace against the opponent. Very interesting choice, stepping in a little bit to serve from the middle of the table and then coming back to step around it on the backhand corner. The block of Li Jiao very steady again. A nice 3-point lead for Li Jiao as she edges near the end of the game. Outstanding placement from Hirano, seeing a little space on the forehand side and loops it right down the line. Shoulders open, letting the hand drag just a little bit as to misdirect the ball, misdirect her opponent and place it on the line. Swiping push over the table. An outstanding block from Hirano to put a lot of pressure for a quick shot. And Li Jiao is now only in the lead by one. From 9-6 to 9-8, has one serve left. And the heavy side spin kicking serve did not bother Hirano, but the block came back. The opening loop of Hirano. Too much pressure on Li Jiao is blocked long, and it's now 9-all. Nippon. Japan cheering Japan in Japanese.
Business end.
The crowd loved that one, Adam. That's four straight points in a row for the hometown favorite, Hirano, from 9-6 now to 10-9. And she's done it, five straight points in a row to save the first game and start it off with a 1-0 lead. Hirano Sayaka of Japan over Li Jiao from the Netherlands, 1-0.
Wow, the tension here continues in the Yoyogi National Stadium in Tokyo. Saturday night, the crowd are in form. Their team is just about winning here this quarterfinal, the last quarterfinal. Only one semi-final berth remains, and it's to face Hong Kong. Sayaka Hirano survived that first game in the end. Japan leading 2-1 in the overall match.
Fast serve deep to the backhand, but the thing that really won it was the heavy underspin. You can see the fan in the front there using his paddle to direct his cheering. A little bit too long, looked like a miss hit for Li Jiao. Clever idea, not afraid to do the long serve. Playing a very young game, serving and stepping around that backhand for the attack.
The crowd there a little bit worried, perhaps. Their players are being tested. Maybe they thought they were coming for a nice, relaxing Saturday night out. Bit of Japanese victory.
Hoping for a 3-0 and not really getting that Japanese victory you were talking about.
That's right. Oh, the feeling in the backhand there from Li Jiao. That's beautiful.
So smooth, just like butter for Li Jiao.
She's focused as well. She's really focused.
We'll get another close-up of her face real soon, and you can see.
Oh,
no way!
Word! Did you hear the rat-a-tat-tat of that? The ball was flying around so much. Watch how quick this goes. Oof. Oof.
Just a flat close hit back on that. Smothering shot, lunging to the forehand side. And Li is on point. Speaking of points, she's up 4-2.
And it's really interesting that both players comfortable at throwing in the long serves. They're not afraid of their opponent attacking the serve.